Chef-driven, guest-focused. That's the motto behind Burntwood Tavern. Opening in 2010, the hotspot has expanded in every direction in Northeast Ohio, including Florida, starting this summer.
And I love coming to Burntwood Tavern. I'm from the area, grew up in the area, and it's just a great place to meet local people. The food is great, the vibe is fantastic, and it's just feels like home.
That feeling of home is what owner Brett Adams creates at each location.
I had a vision of being warm and cozy in Barnwood and very Midwest, coupled with that softer, you know, that elegant, softer elegance, you know, like an upscale tavern. Everything that's in there is authentic.
You see that authenticity as soon as you step through the front door. Right away, you notice the repurposed Ohio Barnwood, the hand-blown glass, and of course, the copper-top bar.
We believe in fate, and each restaurant has its own nuance and own personality, where the elements are similar, but the bones of the building, each building it tells its own story.
It seems fate even played a part in the story of how Burntwood came to be.
Was literally running down the street, and usually I turn left, and instead I ran straight for whatever reason, and saw this building, and a big sign in front of it said fully equipped restaurant for lease. Called the landlord and said, hey, let's take a look at this thing, and really talk through, you know, being chef driven and a copper top bar and warm rustic beams along with some glass, some finesse, so it wasn't so male dominated, so it accommodated both male and female. We signed the lease, and the designer and guy that did construction, Chris Kliniak, he hired two Amish crews to come over and do the demolition, and as we were talking about the wood and the barnwood, there was a barn that was available in Honey Valley. We could tear the barn down and just bring it over here and reclaim it, and then it'll take care of all the wood you need for the restaurant. So a week and a half later, I was sitting in the middle of Honey Valley, literally scratching my head, looking at 5, 6, 7 Amish guys tearing down a barn that's been dilapidated, thinking, I've got every dime I ever saved in a restaurant that's 5 miles away, and I'm sitting in the middle of a field, and it was a very humbling, stressful time.
Exactly.
Fox 8 got a special behind-the-scenes look at another well-known signature of Burntwood Tavern, the drinks, especially their very own house-infused vodkas.
Anything from blueberry to jalapeno garlic, bacon. We utilize them in many facets, whether it's a cocktail for happy hour, whether it's our Jack and Jill with our blueberry vodka, or you want a Bloody Mary for a Bloody Mary bar on Saturdays and Sundays. You can get kind of crazy there. You can do bacon, you know, kind of get that little grease to cure the hangover, or you can do something as like citrus, you know, kind of pull out some flavors from Zig Zag or some of the other mixers that we offer. Here you go, Frank, try that one.
And sometimes the inspiration for bartenders come from the people on the other side of the bar.
A lot of it really is me being behind the bar and talking to our guests. I think a lot of times you think like, ooh, you know, what would Susie like? And she'll start talking to you and she's like, I really love Cosmos. Well, what about a cranberry vodka? You know, let's do something different. Let's take Cosmo and let's make it, you know, the Burntwood Cosmo with our own cranberry vodka and our own lime juice. So, you know, you just really get to talk to them and what people are really looking for.
Burntwood's loyal following is another aspect that makes this restaurant so unique. The VIP group in Chagrin Falls meets there every single day, and it's a tradition that won't end anytime soon.
But, you know, it's fun. We have a good time here. Been coming here for years and years and years, but Brent's done a great job. He's done a great job, and I'm trying to get him to take us to all of his bars. Get a bus, take all of us, especially one in Florida.
There is nothing secret, no secret, nothing magical. We go to bed blessed, and we wake up nervous. That's how we are.